I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed. An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here. Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again, I swear.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me. Now, what to draw? Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab. This place has collected a lot of junk over the years. This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there. A second door inside? So close, and yet so far. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
God, again? What do you want, kid?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Is it past your bedtime?
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid. Because because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room? Sit and spit. Sweet dreams, hombre.
This place is bombed. Okay, good. $20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
No. No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I explained.
Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
I can't hear you.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory. That's like $200. Holy shit, I'm rich. Nothing sadder than a neglected bong. Sketch Central. Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey. Classy. No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis, but I can't.
Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot from me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs, you're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Toss in a dime bag and we'll call it square.
Hey! What are you waving around this kind of money here for? You really don't think before you act, do you?
Nope. So where's my pot?
No more loans. I'm not your fucking piggy bank.
You're a good man, Frank.
No. I'm not. Now beat it, Price. You're cramping my style.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Reminds me of the way I make important life choices. Don't you judge me, spooky deerhead. I'm here for the band.
Damn, there are a lot of people here. Here we go.
Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
She returns.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Are you ready for me? Are you ready for me now? She's been waiting all her life.
should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
This is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? That really was Rachel Amber. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. That was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now. Everything's worth a shot.
Anytime. Literally any amount. We'll take it.
Can't leave without my vitamins. I really should get going. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe! I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. Sigh. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay.
Can you grab my cell phone, too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry. Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Little dude's like, what the hell just happened? Feeling trapped? Right there with you. Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that. Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should, too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. Crap. I forgot David's keys. That's probably worth at least 10 push-ups. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. I made that ashtray for Mom's keys.
Come on, sweetheart. Only. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
Here they are. Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. Nah, school's hardly worth walking to. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted. Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend. Chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10. If it's in my garage, it gets my special treatment. What message does David really need to hear? Got it. Thank you.
tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right. How you do anything is how you do everything.
Now I need a shower. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language? Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot, uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your... I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Oh, that's what I smell. A giant load of crap.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
At least she has a heart. All you have is... What's it called when you've got one porn stash and zero game?
I was in the army. You will respect me.
I don't remember enlisting, so don't treat me like your newest recruit.
If you were a man,
I'd... It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished. Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend. What a beautiful day. I guess Mom left her purse back here. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Whatever.
You're welcome.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
No way. I'd rather have my eyes gouged out with rusted forks.
Yeah, right. Me too, I guess.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah. For sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class. The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole.
Ah, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know? I mean, look at your face.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh. Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe. Students at Blackwell have this herd instinct to glom up into little groups, like sheep. And if you just want to be alone, you get labeled like some dangerous outsider. Just like any other prison. Except now the prison follows you wherever you go, thanks to social media. I can't believe Rachel posted a photo of the two of us together last night. Ladies and gentlemen, Principal Wells. What the fuck is that supposed to mean? No, Chloe. Class is back the other way. Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere. I can tell Justin's wearing his eau de gange.
Damn, girl. That eye looks sick. What's going on?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Oh, no shit. I thought that place was like Meth Central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever.
And
it was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand. Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She is amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it.
C+.
All right. Guess I'll see you in class.
Word.
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
I really don't care that much.
Doing nothing is just as bad as doing harm.
Pretty sure that's not true.
You're back.
Okay, I'll sign this thing.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
Happy to support such an important cause.
Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Thanks so much for signing my petition. Evan is an ass clown.
Aw, don't be so hard on yourself.
No, Chloe.
Class is back the other way.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
Why do you want to know?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Not really in the mood. Maybe later.
You know where to find us.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
have you got here? Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone!
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
Congrats. You've actually got me feeling sorry for Arcadia Bay's most spoiled brat. That's how much of an asshole you're being right now.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
What's crazy is that you haven't been held back yet. How is that possible?
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat!
You shut the fuck up!
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip. That pick would actually make a sweet tattoo. Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people.
Oh, good. You're here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At 20 bucks a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic. That actually kinda helps me. Thanks. Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure. Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? Sweet collar, Pepe. Hey now, sharing is caring. I have feelings about this. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously? RA will suck as Prospera. If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Guess they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing. What to say? Playing the part of the bitter, passed-over, talentless hack, VC. Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now.
Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So?
Did you bring flowers for my dressing room? I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
You call getting attacked by goons amazing? I've got to hang out with you more.
Deal. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Is that a rhetorical question?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Ditch class? You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye. That is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
Yes, please. People won't shut up about it.
Hold still.
This is a lot of makeup.
That's the price of valor. Close your eyes. Much better.
Holy shit.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Sure, you don't want to just grab the bus, or...
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right. Well?
What the hell am I getting into here? Where does this thing go?
North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair. Maybe one of these crates. Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean. I feel pretty confident there's going to be a dead body in here.
thing's heavier than it looks. Guess I should sit down. I see humans, but no humanity. Everybody is somebody, but no one wants to be themselves. Some preachy graffiti up in this train. Human is another word for monster. Just another typical day. Skipping school with Rachel Amber. All right, Chloe, you're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here, so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do? It's nice Rachel we're having.
What?
I mean weather. It's nice weather.
It sure is. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
Hey, so, I want to say thanks.
For pulling you out of school?
No, dummy. Thanks for last night. If you hadn't shown up.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay.
I owe you. That's for sure.
Is that why you came along?
Are you suggesting I should need a reason to ditch school?
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Try again. I'm going to need more to go on than that.
Joyrides with me aren't fun?
Joyrides to where again?
Life needs a little mystery, Chloe. Let's do something fun.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far?
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
No way.
Scared you'll lose?
I'm just not good with people or things.
It'll be fun. Trust me.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
You seem more like a Cali girl to me.
Damn, Price, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast.
I've only ever lived in Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess.
Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we? Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. I once broke my hand punching Stephanie Kowalski in fifth grade.
No way.
Bitch took my yoo-hoo, knocked her the fuck out.
I see you like to write notes to yourself.
Helps me stay focused.
Also, sweet scar.
I used to love country music when I was a kid. Now it makes me want to throw up. Literally.
That's weird.
I used to want to be a pirate when I grow up. I kind of still do.
Arr. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. I'm not sure why country music makes you throw up.
I'm a complex girl, Rachel.
I think it's probably true. Also, I kinda like the Dixie Chicks.
You and David both. No accounting for taste.
Who's David?
He's, the guy my mom's seeing, I guess.
Oh. And you don't like him.
It's still so weird that she's dating someone. My dad and my mom, they were totally in love. You can tell how fucked up she is now just by how she's settling for David. He's this total hard-ass ex-military jagoff type. The opposite of my dad.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. David has no respect. He acts like I'm some kind of problem to solve. Sometimes I am a problem, though.
That's a load of bullshit.
What do you mean?
You're not a problem, Chloe. You're a person. It sounds like the only problem is David. You need to hit him where it hurts.
The only thing that David loves has four wheels and a four-barrel carburetor.
Oh, God. A muscle car?
I'm probably going to steal it soon, so
Let me know if you need an accomplice. Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Buckle swash.
Plunder secret treasure.
Did I mention my love of booty?
So, pirate. Obviously true.
Maybe you'd like to be my first mate.
Oh, are you accepting applications?
Considering it.
Now, about this broken hand story. It's not that I don't think you could knock Stephanie Kowalski out. A bitch takes your yoo-hoo, she's gotta get got.
Damn straight.
But you didn't get that scar from punching someone.
No.
That scar is from a distal radius fracture.
How could you possibly know that?
I broke my wrist when I was 10.
Ah.
The point is, I know that the scar you've got comes with breaking your wrist when you fall. Like, from a skateboard?
Yeah.
I guess 6 years ago?
7. Well, shit. I always thought I was a good liar.
Good thing you're pretty. So, if my math is correct, you told me 2 truths and 1 lie.
What? You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
No, I mean you're really good at this game. It's kind of creepy.
I have a hard time imagining what creeps Chloe Price out. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. And not everyone would admit to wanting to be a pirate.
But eye patches are so cool.
And rum is delicious. Also, you told me about that dickwad David. Now he's on my shit list too.
Hell yeah. Mustache brain won't know what hit him.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
I'm just not really into touchy-feely shit. But I feel like I can trust you.
Yeah?
I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music. Hey, wanna listen?
Thank you. small to this life. If you're honest now, are you coming untied? Are you one of us?
Bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach, or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
What brought that on?
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump! Fuck it!
It's actually a pretty nice view.
Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another one? I like games.
Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we've got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
That blows.
Well, shit. That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her. This whole day is out of order, but in the best possible way.
The lonely oak looks lonely.
Guess even trees have outcasts. Looks like this one might actually be working. Dwight Mueller really killed it with this statue of an explorer guy. Where are all my explorer ladies at, though? Probably at home, washing laundry and spitting out kids.
Fuck you, Dwight.
That is the look of a person who is used to getting what she wants. Wonder what that feels like. That's an old tree. Wait, does this sign say butt rot? Just a day in the park with Rachel Amber. You know when something kind of amazing is happening, you don't always stop to think about it right away? And then when you do think about it, you start thinking about it a lot. And the more you think about it, the crazier it seems, until pretty soon you're psyching yourself out and then everything turns to shit. Yeah, let's not do that today.
Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect. Bye, you fools.
If Max were here, she'd probably take a black and white photograph and call it Innocence Lost, or some shit. I've always said the Prescott family has a couple screws loose. Yuck. Cliche much, AW and OL?
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
Whoa, that's badass. There's gotta be something freeing about being able to build your home wherever you are, from whatever is around you. Hey, spare some change?
Sorry, we might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No, I'm not. What kind of food?
This place has really gone downhill.
Shh, she's right there.
Totally gonna get you that quarter.
Love the confidence. Would love a quarter even more.
Totally gonna get you that quarter.
Love the confidence. Would love a quarter even more.
Huh. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool. I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use? I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
Oh, right.
Sure, let's try it. Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence. Prescott power, activate. I win. That was enough of a game for me.
Your MacGyver skills are second to none. Except, probably, MacGyver.
Rachel smells like jasmine? Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See?
You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God, you just have the best ideas. What's going on with these two? And the Lord saith, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further. Further.
Wow.
That was dark. Too dark. Perfect dark.
Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful in its own way.
Sweet Beanie.
What do you suppose she's thinking?
Nature's Wi-Fi sucks.
Maybe there's a squirrel family around here with broadband.
If only I can guess their password.
We love nuts, 69.
Dingoes ate our babies, 13.
Too soon.
This is fun. Who's next?
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Ooh, jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double.
Rachel? Hey, are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you. They have a bottle of wine. Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead?
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Can we help you? Oh my God!
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance. Better act fast.
What do we do? Oh, thank God. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
Yeah, I'll get right on that.
I bet this dude knows a thing or two about stealing booze. If there were ever a time to skip the signs, this is it. Rachel needs me. And the Oscar for best distraction of wine-toting picnickers goes to Rachel Amber. Better play my supporting role and grab the wine fast.
Are you getting help?
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go! Don't look at me. Look at Baywatch over here. Aw, I don't remember how to do CPR. Wah. It's time to nut up or shut up.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck, right?
I still think you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Look at all the time we've wasted already. This woman needs mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Stat.
No.
Yep. Definitely needs mouth-to-mouth.
Okay. Okay. You can do this. I can't do it.
Pathetic.
Look, he's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing. Hey, look at me! Do you want to be locked out of the car of life forever? Or are you ready to break in there and seize the keys to your potential?
Oh my God. You're right.
Hey, wow. I'm all better now. You saved my life. From the bottom of my heart, thank you. Yeah, good work, everyone. Peace out.
That was incredible. You're a hero.
Huh. I guess I am.
Here. You earned this.
No, thanks. You're the one who really worked for it.
Suit yourself. I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What?
Great.
It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
Chloe, I'd really like some space right now.
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Fuck! Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently, she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
Score.
Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer.
But when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run! Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? I mean, fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what exactly?
You know, like a friendship, but more.
Ah.
I know. Weird, right? It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special. Come on, say something.
Chloe, I'm sorry. I am really, really sorry. But I can't, even though I want to.
Why not? Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe. Fuck this place.
You know she's fake, yet you can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description?
Yeah!
Fuck off, Rachel. Never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras. If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on?
What's past is prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
Hey, where's my marker? Oh, there it is.
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
Dad used to hate it when I wrote on shit. I guess I did that.
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
Rachel! You came. I'm glad.
Are you sure about that? They got kind of a different message this afternoon.
Yeah. Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat and how calm he was and the sound of his voice and he was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation.
I just want you to know I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? You dropped that one guy with a knee to the balls.
Only because you showed up at the last minute and...
What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad?
will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Can I borrow your lighter? Thank you.
No one steals from me! I want my fucking money!